So here's how I planned to do this video. I planned to do like a whole nice little beat face talk through, walk through, and that's not going to be happening, at least not right now, in the next few weeks. Yes, but for this video I just wanted to candidly come on here barefaced and just give you guys like a okay, I just wanted to talk to you guys about what's been going on with my life and just give you an update about what's going on, why I've been absent, why, you know, I haven't been top of things for a while. So let's see, where do I start? Back in February. So, oh good God, could you just stay in one place? Thanks. Okay, so back in February, I was to expect my period, as you know, most women will, you know, at the end of the month or during that month that, you know, supposed to get your monthlies. I had, you know, all the pains, little pains that I get during that week, and, you know, everything seemed to be fine. So a week passed. Next week passed, no period. Okay, another week passed. Okay, this is going on for a bit too long. What's going on? So my husband is like, so why don't you just take a pregnancy test? Take about three. When you go to Pennywise, buy three pregnancy tests. So I'm like, okay, what's the point of taking three pregnancy tests? It's like I have one vagina. I have to pee on one. Like the one is gonna tell me what I need to know. So I go, I get. I ended up buying two, and yeah, so I bought those two. I came home, I think we got food as well, so bought it. So we bought it, went home, I had a bath, and I was like, okay, before we eat, let me do this thing. So I go to the bathroom, I pee. And within like a second, the test came back positive. Two lines, very bright red lines, no mistake in it. It says you're pregnant. And I'm like, I look at it and I'm like, okay. So this is what we're doing now. This is what is happening. This is what we're doing. So I just went. And I had my lunch. I didn't even curse. I didn't say anything. I was just like, okay, this is what we're doing. And I was like, okay, I have to go call the doctor. I called one office. They told me like $1,200. I was like, what? No. So I called a doctor that I really, really liked initially. From the get-go, I really liked her. So I called the office. The Monday, as soon as I can. Okay, so I took the pregnancy test on the Saturday, so I had to wait till Monday. So I was like, okay, called her in the morning, would you be able to come in the afternoon? Yes. So that was that. I went to the doctor on the Monday afternoon. So we had to wait there a little bit extra because homegirl was actually delivering a baby at the point in time of my appointment, and I was like, oh my god. So finally everything is here. I'm on the table lying down with my legs wide open. Bruh. And she's like, I'm gonna do the internal ultrasound. And I'm like, excuse me, you're gonna put that where? In where? So she takes out this little looking ultrasound and she puts it in me, and it's very uncomfortable, by the way. And you know, we are looking, and there's nothing. We see absolutely nothing. She shows me my bladder, she shows me my womb, she shows me my fallopian tubes, she shows me everything, and we can't find anything, like anything at all. So okay, we have to do blood test. So since that appointment is over, go to get the blood test. Next day, I went on the road to get some sada, because sada is life, and breakfast, you know. And come back home now, my husband is looking at me and he's like, doctor's office call. And I'm like, what? I started a cold sweat. I'm like, oh my God, what's going on? What's going on? What to do? What to do? What to do? Okay, call the doctor's office. It's like, okay, is anything wrong? What's going on? It's like, well, your hormone levels, your progesterone levels are very high, and you know there's definitely some sort of pregnancy, but you know we didn't see anything on the ultrasound. So now we're starting to think that, but actually at the appointment the day before, we thought, or there, I mean, the thought part, English. She did mention that it could be a sign of a ectopic pregnancy because you're looking at the ultrasound and we're not seeing anything. So we just want to make sure that the, you know, the cells are not forming in my tube, because then that could, you know, that burst that could cause a whole lot of problems and it could be fatal. So I rushed down the road. I took a bath. I rushed down the road. Go to the doctor's office. She's like, okay, good. Go in. But I had to go by myself this time because hussy has to work. And I go down there by myself. I am still cold sweating in this cold ass office. And, you know, go back up on the doctor's chair. And we do the ultrasound. And there it is. Let me show you guys. So there it is. This very tiny speckle of a dot. I don't even know if y'all could see it. It's like right here. Right there. Right there. Right there. And mind you, I am now 5 weeks pregnant. So in my mind, I immediately start to calculate, when was the last time I had sex? When, where, how, and what? So, okay, we confirmed pregnancy. I'm pregnant. I'm 5 weeks, a whole 5 weeks pregnant. And I'm just here like, okay. I have no feeling. I don't feel happy. I don't feel sad. I don't feel mad. I just don't know how to feel about the whole thing. I just don't know. I'm just like in this space of not, I wouldn't say numbness, but I'm just in this space of being unsure, like, what is happening? This is new to me. And you know, I just didn't know how to feel. I really didn't know. My husband, however, he was just so excited when I showed him the ultrasound picture. When I came back home that morning, he literally, I was sitting on the bed, he was sitting on the bed, and I showed it to him, and he literally dived his head into my stomach, very gently dived his head into my stomach, and he was like, oh my God, he starts squealing. It was like, it was really, really sweet. He was really, really excited and happy and proud, and I'm just here like, okay. Yeah, okay, all right, okay, yeah. So fast forward now to 5, 6, 7, 8. So we are the 8th week now. So during the 8th week, during the 7th to 8th week, yeah, during that week, there was signs of a bit of bleeding. And I was a bit worried because like about 3 times during that week, there were signs of bleeding. And you know, I started thinking about, oh my God, what about if I had a miscarriage? What's going on? I don't know what is going, because you know the internet will tell you like a million different things have gone wrong. You could probably have cancer, you would have, you know, fallen a nail and hit your head and that's why you're bleeding, you know, all these different kinds of things. So I'm feeling, you know, really, really down. I didn't want to do anything. I was just totally out of everything. So I go to the doctor, and then that was a Thursday. Yeah, I go to the doctor on a Thursday, and you know, we do another ultrasound, and by this time the dot is not a dot anymore. It's a yolk. It's like, it looks like an egg yolk. And she does her checks, everything seems fine, you know, there's nothing to be worried about. And since that visit, I haven't had any problems with bleeding or signs of bleeding spotting or anything like that. So, good. So now I'm starting to feel the effects of pregnancy. I'm starting to feel the fatigue, the nauseousness. I am so super tired. Listen to me, there were a few times I went to sit down by the computer and do some work. I literally started doing this. I was like, I just go and close my eyes for a little bit. And close my eyes for a little bit went from like about 10 minutes to 4 hours or 5. There was one particular day I slept the entire day. I probably got up to pee. Oh, and my name is Pina now, because I pee probably 4 to 5 times in an hour. It is so sickeningly annoying. Whew, let me tell you something. I have never peed this much in my entire life. I have never peed this much. I don't even think that I'm drinking the amount of water that I should. And if I do start drinking the amount of water that I should, that's it for me. I'll be going to pee 20 times an hour. It is so, so annoying. Like, I can't even describe to you how annoying it is. It's like, I'm in the middle of doing something. I'm lying down. I want to sleep. And that is the biggest thing for me right now. So, at the point of this video, at the time that I'm making this video, I am at 10 weeks. So, now, during this time now, I'm not feeling as tired, but I'm feeling more so a bit sick. So I'm feeling the nauseousness more than anything else. I have probably thrown up twice since this whole pregnancy, and but the nausea is really, really getting to me. If it is I do not eat on time, I want to vomit. If I eat a little too much, which I haven't been doing, but I would feel to vomit as well. It's definitely a really, really crazy experience. I've been having headaches. I've just wanted to lie down and do absolutely nothing. Like, I feel totally drained. My body is just like, make this child. This is all you are going to do right now. Form this child, make this child, do nothing else. That is how my body feels right now. My body's just been telling me that for the past 10 weeks. That's my ring light. Hold on, let me get my shit together. Okay, I got my shit together. So yeah, that's what my body has been telling me for the last 10 weeks. And I have just been, you know, trying to really take it slow. And it's really, really, really difficult to concentrate on work because I'm just feeling so sick. And now that my uterus is starting to stretch, I'm getting a lot of pains in my lower abdomen, down by my womb. I'm starting to feel, you know, the stretching, and so it hurts. I have these, you know, times where I'm like, ooh. Actually, earlier on, like during the 5th week, during that time, I would have these ridiculously intense, sharp pains. They would last for a few seconds, but I would be totally... it would totally take me out. I would be like, whoo, 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 and blowing because the pain was that intense. I would just be walking and give me a few seconds because I can't make. I really can't make. Today, I'm actually feeling just a little bit better. So I've been able to sit here and talk to you guys about this. So, 10th week. So this is the 10th week. Last Friday would have been the 10th week. So as I'm making this video, this is within the 11th week. This Friday will be the 11th week of pregnancy. So I go to the doctor on last Friday to do my next checkup, my other monthly checkup. And through, you know, reading and looking up, you know, I would have known like what, you know, how the fetus is going to look at this point. And nothing, and I'm telling you, nothing could have prepared me for the feeling that I experienced while looking and in that ultrasound monitor. Like, it was like nothing I have ever, ever experienced in my entire life. I mean, I was nervous all morning. I was extremely nauseous that morning. Extremely. Like, I had to, like, I was feeling every single bump in the road. I had to take a mint. I didn't eat anything for breakfast that morning, so I was extremely hungry. I ran to the pharmacy to get some mints, because mints actually hold me down if I'm traveling. You know, if I'm in the car, I need to have a mint to actually help, you know, settle my stomach, because I would be really, really a Debbie Downer in any trip. So I've been kind of bracing from going to the beach because it's a long ride. And I would want to pee, and I want to vomit, I would feel sick. I'm a real hot basket case right now. Anyways, back to this ultrasound. So we go to the doctor to do this ultrasound. And as I said, nothing could have prepared me for what I saw on the monitor. I legit, the tears just started to flow. I don't know where they just came from, but I just started to cry because I was like, this is happening inside of me. Like, this is actually happening. Like, I could not. Let me just show you guys. So I'm sorry that the I think the doctor's toner was running out, but yeah, this is my little pumpkin right here. Yes, this is my little pumpkin, and that's the heartbeat. Listen to me, I think when I heard that heartbeat is when that was it for me. That was it for me. I really couldn't hold it in. I was just crying. I was lying on the table and tears running down the side of my face. And I'm like, it's my baby. It's like little fingers and toes. Listen to me. That child was moving. Like, I thought that, you know, you would just see the baby there just floating in his amniotic. I'm saying the word wrong. In his fluids and just there. No. This child is legit doing somersaults inside of there. And I'm like, would you stay still? And the doctor's like, wow, this baby is so active. And I'm like, yes, this child. And listen to me, I'm seeing the two hands, I am seeing fingers, I am seeing the legs, I'm seeing the feet, I am seeing toes, I'm seeing the head, and I am just in awe. This came from this little dot that we could hardly see to now 10 weeks. And I'm seeing the formation of a human being. And I was just praying, like, you know, during this pregnancy, holding my stomach, rubbing it. I mean, it's mostly fat right now because I'm fat and, you know, there's no bump, visible bump yet. I mean, I'm feeling, honestly, I know my clothes and the things I cannot wear right now, like my jeans cannot fit me. My jeans feel very tight. I have to wear yoga pants and anything stretchy, leggings, dresses, whatever. But I'd been praying, Lord, please, you know, form my baby right. Just everything a mother would pray for. I think a mother would pray for, you know, in the formation of a child, that everything goes well. And just seeing that monitor, seeing the ultrasound and hearing that heartbeat, it was one of the most fantastic, I can't even describe it. It just felt so surreal at that point. Like, I couldn't, I was looking at my husband, he's looking at the monitor like in awe, and I'm there with tears. Oh my God, it was really, really a defining moment in my life. I've never experienced anything like this. I've never felt this way before. And after that visit, that's when I actually started feeling something. Like, it's just seeing the hands and the feet, it's just seeing the formation of the baby in there. Because at this point, the baby is like the size of a prune. It's like this big. Seeing the formation of the baby just made me actually feel so much emotion. So now I'm like, I'm actually going to be a mother. Like, I'm actually feeling like that. I'm feeling very fuzzy and warm, and you know, I'm cradling my stomach a little bit more, my fat, because I'm cradling my fat. She met me by the doctor. I'm like, well, I don't know when my bump is going to start to show because, you know, a fat. And my doctor's like, I'm like, you can't even like say, you know, someone else is like, He's like, yeah, oh God, we know a fat, but my God. I have a lot of trouble falling asleep. Sleep is not my friend. Any nighttime, my lower abdomen feels, I'm getting those little pains. I call them growing pains, so I feel it. My breasts have gotten very much more tender. My nipples are sticking out all the time for absolutely no reason and embarrassing me, so I always have to stuff them. Yeah, I'm just tender overall. My nails have been growing ridiculously. I have to file and cut my nails every week, like religiously, because they grow so much. My hair, I have to go get my hair tightened up tomorrow because my hair has been growing ridiculously. Last time I got my hair done was in December. Yeah, it's March. So yeah, I have to go get my hair done ASAP. I have to apologize to a few people. I've lied to a few people about this pregnancy. I have lied to my sister. My sister asked me if I was pregnant and I said no. We were supposed to go out. Actually, we did go out. We went to the mall to hang out and talk and whatnot, and I could not tell her a single thing. Because during that week, actually, Chanel, that is when I had the concerns about me having a miscarriage, and I was feeling really, really down that week. So I wasn't feeling myself at all. I was really worried, and that is why I lied. Well, I lied because it was too early to tell anybody anything. So I was like, no, I'm not pregnant. And then earlier on, I spoke to Denise. Hi, Denise. So in casual conversation, Denise asked me if I was pregnant, and I was like, no. I'm not pregnant. I was pregnant that whole time too. So yeah, I think I'm gonna tell her. I'll tell her before this video actually comes out. But yeah, lied. Sorry. there's somebody else that I lied to, but I probably lied to a few people. I was like, no. Oh yes, my friend. I lied to a friend of mine. Actually, not really. She asked me if I had intentions of having children, and I was like, yeah, you know, in the future eventually. And this whole time I'm like, now I was like approaching 10 weeks at that time. So I'm sorry, honey. I'm sorry I lied. I'm so sorry that I lied to you.
The woman is the greatest liar upon the earth.
But did I really lie though?
Lie again. Lie. Liar, them is the biggest liar.
I don't. Did I really lie? I just curbed the truth a bit. But, you know. Alternative facts. No, that's not alternative facts. I just curbed my way out of the truth there for a while. Anyways, but yeah, I was not very forward with a lot of people about what was going on with me. So yeah, I have to take it really easy during COVID. I have to be very, very extra careful. I'm gonna be inside a lot. It really, really annoys me that I can't be out and about as I would like. Most of the out and about that I do is getting exercise. So we try probably like 3 times for the week. That is sometimes once or twice. But I do make the effort to move about and, you know, still get in that exercise. I haven't put on any weight since this pregnancy. I lost like 1 pound during the whole during these few weeks so far. And that was because during that week I was feeling really nauseous and I wasn't eating as much. I was very, very picky. In terms of what I eat. So that could be for a different video, but I will say this. My husband and I have been more on a pescatarian diet, so we eat a lot of fish, seafood, and whatnot. This baby is not having that. I have been craving chicken, I've been craving meat, I've been craving wings. I love wings, I've been craving wings. I've been just craving meat on the whole, so I'm very glad that I've been able to have some meat, because meat. And I think it's because of the iron. I need a lot of iron, so I have to get some more folic acid. Mental reminder to write that on my book. Yeah, so I have a book that I make notes about during this pregnancy. Yeah, just to, you know, just to document everything, you know. This is my first time, and I just want to document everything, and, you know, have it as a keepsake, you know, get shared with my little bundle of joy at some point in his or her life. Am I concerned whether I would like a boy or a girl? I used to think that mattered. It doesn't matter. Being pregnant, I realize it really doesn't matter. Like, to me, it doesn't matter. I'm like, as long as I have a healthy baby, physically, mentally, that's all I care about. I really don't care if I have a boy or a girl. I don't even know if I want to know yet. I think I want it to be a surprise. My husband is like, I'm having a surprise. I just want a healthy baby. That's all. That's all that I'm praying for. And yeah. And that's it. I don't think there's anything that I'm forgetting. But if you find that I've been distant, guys, that is why. I have been pregnant and going through it with this pregnancy and feeling sick and tired. So, yay! I'm pregnant! At this point, I haven't told my family anything. It's only my husband, myself, the doctor, and the doctor's assistant knows anything about this. My family doesn't know anything. I haven't told any friends. Nobody knows anything. We plan to tell them this week. So you guys will be seeing this probably in the 12th week, or probably sooner than that. Yeah, so hold on, I need to take a phone call. Yeah. All right. Yeah, let me take down all these things and go take a nap. I'm starting to get really tired now. So bye, guys. And I don't know what else to say. This is a very different video. I don't know what else to say. Normally I'd be like, well, bye guys. Look at my eyes, look at my shadow. Yeah, I'm pregnant. Bye.